when you believe, when you believe exactly 100% in anything, you can do it. You can do it. Myself, I believe that I'm strong enough to continue struggling for this situation. I feel that I'm free, really. Even I'm under watching. So myself, I'm going in my way. I don't feel anything else.
The daily harassment was always there. I mean, his phone was always tapped. He was followed. They were watching who he meets with and who he talked to. There was always, you know, guards at his outside his office. They would even try to scare clients, you know, from coming and hire him. So they made life difficult for him.
One of those very high level in intelligence service asked me one time. He asked me, "You sleep directly?" I said, "When I put my head on the bed, automatically I go in deep sleep." I said, "Do you know why?" He said, "No." I said, "Because my heart, I feel that I am doing good things for the people."
Les Syriens ont le sentiment, mais plus que le sentiment, c'est-à-dire qu'ils savent par expérience que ils sont surveillés, ils sont sous surveillance.
Il n'y a pas de liberté d'expression, il n'y a pas de liberté de circulation. Bon, j'ai une amie qui ne peut pas sortir de Syrie, par exemple. Il y a beaucoup de Syriens, des milliers de Syriens, ou bien ils n'ont plus leur passeport, ou bien ils sont sur des listes. Quand ils arrivent à l'aéroport, on leur dit non, vous ne partez pas.
Le régime sait que sa situation n'est pas aisée, n'est pas facile. Le régime sait qu'il est, grosso modo, illégitime. Il y a des procédures qui accompagnent la décision de l'état d'urgence. Et cet état d'urgence doit être pris, décidé pour un objectif déterminé, et il doit être renouvelé tous les 6 mois. Or, l'état d'urgence est une réalité qui dure en Syrie sans que personne ne se pose plus le problème.
ما يحكي بالكلام انه في قوانين طوارئ انه في معتقلين انه في تعذيب بالسجون انه في كمش اطفال بدون سبب في ارهاب بالبلد حقيقي في رشوه في فساد بيقول الكواكبي في كتابه انه الدكتاتوريه النظام الشمولي هو أبو كل الفساد بيقوم.
I have no enemy. I work. I said to him, I work by street. All the people like me. So what do you need more than this? I'm a very rich man because this is life. This is my philosophy.
He begs people sometimes to come and file lawsuits, you know, against the government and what they are doing. And he would say, I'll do it for free. He just want people to come and stand up for their rights.
En 51, il a commencé à militer pour les droits de l'homme. En 89, il a travaillé avec Amnesty International. Il a toujours défendu les droits de l'homme pour n'importe qui, même des gens qui n'y croyaient pas, des gens religieux, des gens pas religieux, laïcs. Enfin, pour lui, c'est l'individu qui compte ses droits.
Yes, I spent 7 years of my life in jail, beginning of 1980, last of 1986. Do you hear me?
لا تحس انه تحس انك كعرفته من زمان كانك تعرفه ونحن كنا نعرف انه من المحامين الذين سجنوا في مطلع الثمانينات حينما قامت حركه النقابات المهنيه في سوريا تطالب حافظ الاسد في اطلاق الحريات والغاء الاحكام العرفيه هاي حركه النقابات المهنيه والمجتمع المدني ولذلك هو وقتها الغى أولا حل هذه النقابات التي كانت تشكلت بناء على مرسوم هو أصدره.
I don't know why, but it happened. I received usually a telephone call from all over the world. I received from Russia, from Afghanistan, from Pakistan, from Europe. Lot of people for me asked for some people in jails, or I don't know from where they take or they got my telephone number or my email. I don't know.
C'est un monsieur qui a beaucoup de compassion. Plusieurs fois lors de nos entretiens, je l'ai vu pleurer en évoquant les difficultés des familles qui venaient le voir parce qu'elles ignoraient où se trouvaient des parents à eux, un père, un frère ou d'autres qui avaient été enlevés et qui n'étaient pas réapparus depuis 20 ans, 25 ans ou 30 ans.
استاذ هيثم المالح كان تشغله جدا التفاصيل الصغيره لاعتقال كل شخص من الاشخاص. لا يعرف كثير من الاهل اين ابنهم، اين اباهم، اين اخوهم. استاذ هيثم المالح بفضل بعض الزيارات التي تتم له كان يقوم بمحاوله تهريب بعض المعلومات عن وجود المساجين داخل السجن.
فعنده طريقة في الحديث وبالأسلوب جذابة وآسرة، وأحيانا يستعمل النكتة بحيث أن الحديث يبقى له فيه حيوية وطعم خاص.
Il dit ce qu'il pense et il fait ce qu'il dit.
فهو يدخل لك الموضوع حتى الموضوع الذي يكون قانونيا وجافا وجامدا، ولكن يقدمه لك بأسلوب عذب، بأسلوب إنساني وأسلوب مرح.
Yeah, I said this is a special saying in Syria. Mosquitoes sleep over an ass of buffalo. In the morning, the mosquitoes said to the buffalo, good morning. The buffalo asked the mosquitoes, where you were? But she didn't feel her.
فقال له الضابط ليش رجعت انت؟ نحن قايلين بدنا نعتقلك اذا رجعت. فقال له يعني خليك برا، يعني ابقى في الخارج. فقال له انا ابن دمشق مثل جبل قاسيون هذا، يعني انا دمشقي راسخ في دمشق، عميق الجذور في دمشق، مثل جبل قاسيون.
Il avait une attitude à son régime qui était une attitude de résistance, mais de résistance dans le cadre du respect de la loi. C'est-à-dire ce qu'il voulait, c'était que les autorités syriennes respectent elles-mêmes les lois qu'elles avaient imposées au pays.
I think maybe that used to bother me is like when we are at home and in the evening he'll tell me, you know, to prepare him. Do you know makdous? Makdous is like a stuffed eggplant. And it's like pickled. I don't like it myself, but my father always in the evening, you know, he used to tell me, go bring me a makdous, you know, one makdous and like two eggs, you know, boiled eggs. And so I'm first of all, I don't like makdous. I don't like its smell. I don't like, but I have to go, you know, get it for him, and I have to make the eggs. And so, and this is something that I never liked really working in the kitchen. So that's something, you know, that bothered me, you know, maybe a little bit. But every night I have to.
This is life. This is my philosophy in life. Even I am in, really, I am in dangerous, but I don't care. I believe in God. I believe that my life in the hand of God, not in the regime. The regime couldn't do anything against me.